Hey guys, it's James here from the Movie Mad Channel, and today is Sunday, and look at the state of me, a bit rough like, dear oh dear. But what I've done is I got up early and I went to the car boot sale just to have a look around, because it's open now, which is pretty good. It was very spread out, very distanced, and everyone was being social distancing, so that was pretty good. So I thought I would just have a, and I only stayed 20 minutes. I just walked around quickly and had a quick look. I took a very small bit of footage, which I might upload into the video. But I picked, this is what I picked up. So I picked up, I picked up this set for 25p. That's the Descent, Dog Soldiers and 28 Days Later. Now I've got those, the 28 Days Later on Blu-ray. I've also got Dog Soldiers on DVD already, but my disc is all scratched and I don't have the Descent. So for 25p, I thought I'll pick up the Descent and I'll replace my DVD copy of Dog Soldiers. Now, I know a lot of people have been, have got a bit of the Blu-ray Dog Soldiers, but that was filmed on 16mm, so really, Blu-ray is not really going to make any difference, I don't think, to it. And also some of the footage was lost, I think. Is some of the footage not on the Blu-ray and it is on the DVD? Somebody could let me know, that would be appreciated. So I picked that up for 25p. And when I say 25p, it was four for a pound. So what I'd done is I did see this one here, which I actually quite fancied, and that's The Children of Dune with James McAvoy. Never seen that. So, two-disc edition on DVD. So that's a nice one. That's a nice one to take. So I picked that one up. And Frank Herbert's Dune was the beginning. 12 years since the... I'll have to watch Dune before I watch this again, won't I? So that's another one. And this one I picked up because it says Charlton Heston and it's Solar Crisis. Never ever heard of that, but whatever somebody was having, this surely can't have been £71.30 as it says in the back. Solar Crisis. The crew of the Helios on a high-risk mission investigate a massive solar flare, and Charlton Heston's in it from 2002. Wonder if the movie's actually from 2002, but... So those were the three. I thought that's pretty good for my pound. And I couldn't find a fourth one, so I picked up Toy Story. And I was going to trade it in, but you only get 20p for it, but... No, 20p's burning out, I suppose. Get my 20p back. And I also picked up from a guy who was there. Honestly, look at this state of me. Game of Thrones Season 7 on DVD. And I picked that one up for a pound. And I want to own it on Blu-ray. But the Blu-ray version is a bit more expensive at the moment. And so I thought I'd pick up on DVD, but then I thought I'm always going to want the Blu-ray, so why don't I just take it and trade it in, and you get £7 for that, so that's a pretty good deal. Get that, and with those ones, what you can do is you can always pick it up later, because it'll drop down in price on Blu-ray, and at some point, and I've got my £7 voucher and got something else, but then maybe another series of The Walking Dead to get up to my... up to speed on my collection. He also had Season 6, which I took for a pound as well, and Season 5, but Season 6 and Season 5 didn't have the outer case, so I don't know if CX will take them or not. I don't think they will, so maybe that was a waste of a pound. And I've also got the Star Trek Deep Space Nine Season 6. I did buy that the other day there, but I actually had Season 6, but that's me completed all the Deep Space Nine collection now, so I won't have to be looking out for them anymore. But Season 6 you get £2 for, so I'm going to take those to CEX and trade them in. Probably not Season 6 because we probably won't take it, but and then I'll have a look around Poundland and I might do a bit of film, might do a bit of filming. I did do a bit of filming in HMV yesterday, which I might add into today's hunt, and I might have a look at a couple of charity shops. So there we go, off we go. I'll see you in a little while. Yeah. Let's see what they drink. Here we go. That looks like it's on the same stuff. That's the Cars 3 with a stop there. Now we'll go back to that picture. That range of course not. That's okay, I think it'll be Sour Cars Range. I'm actually looking for that one. So there was none in Thailand, as you can see. So I'm going to go to the Heart Foundation and have a look in here. See if there's any. Somebody just bought a big bag of DVDs. Jesus. Let's see Alex what we've got. Big finger in the way, I'm sure you appreciate that. I don't know.
Jason, this is the one I was talking about for you. Look, I looked at the J card, but the J card is a wee bit crinkled on it, so this looks not too bad for you. Surgeant. I'm going to pause this for a second. That's there. Into this, so that's key. Good boy, yeah. Very good. Yeah, good. It's a great movie, Moneyball. I enjoy that one. My darling Clinton. I like that, but it's on Amazon for $9.99. It's a bit. Oh, rabbit from one of the ones. It's not got a case or anything. Play, so play. Oh, what the hell is this? Things just come in. Eureka on here. Yes. What's this one? I can't follow. This is very cute. Yeah. It's really hard, but that one. Lots of ones I don't know, but they don't trick right there. Vengeance from the Jim Fort Maddox of the Visit. Is that room? Oh, that's a book. Oh, must have stopped filming there. Don't know where that stuff happened. Yes. I'm a stranger, of course, from second sight. Oh! There's the film I watched the other night. I can't believe that one. That's the bit of fish in the moon, that's really. Right, off we go. Yeah, guys. Yeah. There we go. Right, not too bad, not too bad. That wasn't too bad. Well, funny thing, this fella did it well, I don't know. Oh, there you go. Joys of a YouTuber. Or, I'm not a YouTuber. I just put the things up I like to show people. Oh well, let's see what I'll get to the next, when I head to the next area. And see you there. Next time. Bye. Thank you. I've got a good selection. I need to get it. Well, I know, yeah. I think I could do another two.
Hi guys, so I'm back from my movie hunting few hours. I think I spent two or three hours going around the shops and having a look, and I'll show you what I got. So, as I say, I took some stuff out of trading at CX, took the voucher. There was a couple of things there, but I just kept my voucher for now. And I picked up these in the British Heart Foundation. 127 hours. I don't know if I've actually got this in the house, I don't think I do. But for three for a pound, I thought I'd take that. So I picked that one up. And if I don't, I think it's a double case anyway, so that's handy. The second one I picked up was this one. As you can see, it's probably Heather Graham in Blessed. And that is a movie that I haven't seen. And I thought, oh, that's nice, a thriller. And I couldn't find the third one in that Heart Foundation, so I picked up Senna, and it says triple play DVD, so to be honest with you, it's just for the double case, because I've already got this one. So there you go. So that was three I picked up in the Heart Foundation, in my first Heart Foundation. I say I drove to another one, because there were a few other shops on my second route, and I had a look, and when I went in, immediately seen five Blu-rays in there, and they're three for a pound. Cloverfield, which I don't think I own on Blu-ray, so I picked up. I didn't like Cloverfield that much, to be honest with you, but I certainly really enjoyed 10 Cloverfield Lane. That's a really good one, so picked up Cloverfield. I have this already, and that's Alfred Hitchcock's The Birds on Blu-ray. But for 33p, it trades in for 2 at CEX, so that'll probably be going to the CEX. Shooter, I don't think I've got that on Blu-ray. I've definitely got it on DVD, but I don't think I've got it on Blu-ray. So I've seen this, I thought it was okay. And is it a double disc one? No, it's just a single disc one. But Matt Warburg in Shooter, so I'll pick that one up as well. Oh, what else did I get? The New World. I've got that on DVD, but I certainly don't have it on Blu-ray. And the New World Extended Cut with Coral Farrell. I think I remember watching this, but can't remember much about it. So, again, another one. So it was well worth going to that second Heart Foundation. And the last one I picked up was Rear Window, another Alfred Hitchcock one with James Stewart and Grace Kelly, 60th anniversary. Again, that trades in for £2, but I don't have that one, so I'll probably be keeping that. In fact, I'll most likely definitely be keeping that one. So there you go. So that was what the ones there. So that was five, and I found a couple of DVDs that I fancied in the three for a pound as well. So I found, what was the first one I found? You know, Brighton Rock. This looks like Richard Attenborough. Is that Richard Attenborough? It is, New and Sealed, Brighton Rock. And again, that looked like a film that I would enjoy. I also found Sharknado 5. I've got, is that, or is that just Sharknado? No, it's Sharknado 5. Sharknado 5 is number 5. Guy at 90210, remember that? Tara Reid, and the, I don't know who the other person is, but you know what? The movies, you can't take them seriously, but I haven't even seen Sharknado, the first one. But I've got one on Blu-ray. I thought, why not pick up 5? And Lindsay Lohan, and I Know Who Killed Me, looking very grown up on the front rather than our teen Walt Disney movies, yeah? So there you go, Lindsay, I Know Who Killed Me. Oh, looks like it's a horror. And because I couldn't find one more, actually, I quite liked Tim Allen, so I picked up The Shaggy Dog. Kids will like that one. You know what? I done a rookie mistake. I never checked any of the discs on the DVDs. But, oh, look at that. Shaggy Dog's perfect. So that is my Blu-ray hunting for Sunday. Not too bad. I think I spent a total of £3. Oh, I tell a lie. £4. £4, my apologies. I spent £3 at the car boot sale this morning and £4 on movies today, so that's a total of £7. And I've traded in £8 worth already, and I've got another £2 trade in there as well as that bunch of DVDs, so I've got £9 back, all of those. So that's why I like to hunt on a budget. I think it's more enjoyable. I think I can get more things for my money. I spent more on my juice, £1.50 for a bottle of Coke. Cherry Coke though. I've indulged myself. I've been, see, if I have this in the house, I'll just drink it and drink it and drink it. So I don't. So very, very occasionally. I think this is the first one I've had in about 3 months. So that cost more than there. And I got that in Sainsbury's when I was having a look at the movies. But their section was totally reduced to absolutely nothing. And there was another few shops I could have went to, but I thought I've spent enough time hunting movies. Probably time to edit this video together and maybe watch some. So thanks very much for watching, guys. If you do like the videos, please give it a thumbs up, please subscribe, and I'm going to try and do something about my face. Well, you know what I mean, I don't know what that is. Jesus. Oh well, see you later on, guys. Bye.